大家好，欢迎收看我们今天英文翻译第16次播出。今天我们要谈英汉文化的对比与翻译第二部分。首先来介绍跟我一块主持节目的魏老师。
我是魏彻德，欢迎收看。今天的题目是文化跟翻译。
好，谢谢。那首先来看我们今天要谈的 Principles of Translation 翻译原理。在上一次跟今天这两个讲次，我们都在谈英汉文化的对比与翻译。我们发现要做好翻译，文化背景有相当的认识哈。那么上次我们谈到了中西的饮食啦，还有婚礼喜宴啊，还有个经典名著。今天我们继续谈文化意象和中西成语。首先看一下文化意象，我们知道各个文化都有它常常含有特殊一些含义的意象。英语中有许多文化的意象跟我们中文的文化意象是蛮相同的，当然有很多不同啦。那文化意象其实各民族他们智慧情感的个精华，他们凝聚了人们对于自然景物的认识还有情怀，而且他们就是这千古传留在我们的神话当中，在我们的图腾里面，还有文艺作品之中，其实这样代代相传，成为各种民族语言中一个文化的符号，也是一些丰富的词汇。那中西文化意象的差异表现在我们今天谈在动物上在植物上，还在颜色上，其实蛮非常明显的。首先看看植物的意象，我们中国文化中对于松、梅、竹、兰极为推崇，我们说松柏长青哈。松树代表着人物的清高，我们有松风水月这个说法。那人品的坚贞呢，譬如说松柏后雕，更可形容妇女的节操，有如松柏岁寒不改其苍翠之色，有松操薄节的说法。梅花在寒冬的时候花蕊会绽放，那么雪中独秀，有白洁坚忍之喻哈。还有一个我们常讲到梅妻鹤子，就指宋朝隐士林波哈，他没有娶也没有儿子，但在西湖这孤山中呢，种梅养鹤，比喻人品的清高。那竹青翠哈挺拔，那么枝叶很这个茂密，所以晋朝有这个竹林七贤之称，我们还记得的话哈，那有这个竹林之友啦，比喻说是清高之友。那兰花也是个意象，兰花幽香清远，所以君子贤人就是兰石啊，比喻着高尚的这种节操。所以松梅竹兰在汉语中它象征着清高，象征着亮洁哈。但是在英语当中好像没有什么特殊的含义哈。英语中它有些别的植物确实具有一些文化的意象，我们举例说明，譬如说橄榄枝哈 ，an olive branch， 它象征和平和和解。那么起源是于旧约这个挪亚他从方舟，当时有40天昼夜这个大雨之后，他从方舟呢就放出一个鸽子，那么鸽子回来呢，嘴巴衔着橄榄树的树枝回来，就表示已经水退了，那么大地呢再度恢复了平静。我们今天看看在联合国国旗的这个图案也采用这个橄榄树枝哈。那么另一个我们叫棕树枝 ，a branch of the palm tree， 哈，也富有宗教含义。在新约圣经曾经描述耶稣进耶路撒冷城的时候，那迎接者呢，多半手中持有棕树枝，所以这个 palmer 哈，就表示有进香客、朝圣者之意。另外一种树叫做 elm 榆树哈，因为它常常被用来做棺木的材料。所以有这个坟墓啦或死亡的联想。在英国古老的教会墓地 也常见到这个龙冲的这紫山哈 ，yu， 所以它也是有一个死亡的象征。另外一个我们叫做laurel 月桂冠，这要讲到希腊的时候，在希腊竞技大赛中呢，是象征胜利哈，优胜者都要戴上月桂冠叶，所以月桂冠呢是 Apollo 这个神哈他的树，那因此它跟预言和诗的灵感都有关系。因而我们今天把月桂冠代表的胜利、和平还有文才哈，例如有桂冠诗人。我想先问问看Charles 老师 ，Charles， would you please summarize the symbolic meanings of olive branch and the laurel？
Yes, the olive branch symbolizes peace, and it appears on the flag of the United Nations. And laurel, like you said just now, is a symbol of victory since ancient Greece. You know, we have the expression "rest on your laurels," meaning be complacent.Be satisfied with what you've already achieved. And,
Yeah. 好，就是一个满足的意思了哈。Satisfied.好，那我们先看，刚刚是说这个植物一些中西不同的意象。那我们看看动物，其实也蛮有趣的哈。因为我们汉语中运用许多动物的意象。你想想看，人一出生就跟十二生肖有关系。那么中西动物中差异最大的可能是那个龙哈。中国人一向以龙作为说这个尊贵。吉祥的象征，譬如有龙袍、龙殿都是帝王之比喻。那龙虎龙凤，比喻是优秀人才。还有龙象虎视表示这个志气很高远哈。那么在西方呢，这个龙就 dragon， 其实跟 devil 魔鬼有关哈。最早有一个叫做这个圣乔治 Saint George， 他有屠龙的传说。如果我们回到新约圣经哈，在他最后一本书《启示录》里面有讲到 dragon 哈 serpent devil， 这个都是跟 Satan 这个魔鬼撒旦有关。那么在 the 所谓的 the old serpent， 其实指呢这旧约圣经旧约创世纪当中，在伊甸园里面这个撒旦哈变成一个大的蛇啊 serpent， 他来诱惑。我们这个夏娃这个女的哈老祖母啦，那么就要偷尝了禁果，所以这个蛇今天在西方我们说形容词 snaky 就表示邪恶、狡猾、阴险。那在中国文化当中，蛇好像并没有那么邪恶的感觉哈。有时候我们说，哎，龙蛇可以比喻非常的人才啦。那么蛇年就是小龙年哈，甚至有像这个《白蛇传》。非常凄美的爱情故事，所以东西对动物也是有不同的解读啦。我们汉族古代这个建筑有这个有倒挂这个蝙蝠哈为饰哈，取蝙蝠之谐音叫做福道哈，那表示幸福、吉祥、健康的意思。但在西方这个蝙蝠 bat， 因为它是昼伏夜出，与黑暗有关，而且很多巫师这种 witches 哈，他做法多半会用到这个 bat 这蝙蝠哈，所以在西方民俗中，这个蝙蝠呢，如果闯入了这个住宅，就是好像死亡不祥之兆。Charles， why are dragon and snake symbols of the evil things in Western culture？
Because in the Bible, Satan took the shape of a snake, a serpent, and he seduced Eve to eat the fruit of the tree of knowledge, knowledge of good and evil, and so Adam and Eve were driven now out of paradise, out of the Garden of Eden. And then in the book of Revelation, the dragon is another representation of the devil.
启示录里面也是一样的 devil. 好，我们先讲到这里，休息一下。好，我们谈到这中西文化意象的这个对比，除了这个植物以外、动物以外，还谈一个颜色哈。那么色泽其实中西也有点不大一样。我们中国人喜欢红色，表示喜气洋洋；西方人喜欢这个红色是红色玫瑰，表示很 passion 很热情。中国丧葬仪式穿白色丧服哈，那有时候会着这个黑色代表哀伤，但西方它通常都是用黑色哈。中国帝王贵族喜欢黄色，表示权势，所以黄袍不是黄袍加身。那么西方 皇宫贵族喜欢用紫色哈，或者蓝色，所以说他们那个贵族的血液不是红色，是蓝色，叫 blue blood， 表示贵族的血统。那么中国绿色除了年轻新嫩以外，好像没有特殊的含义，但英语当中我们看还有 green eyed， 表示嫉妒的。那么莎士比亚剧本当中有写到 green eyed jealousy， 就是马克白里面哈，还有 the green eyed monster， 在奥赛罗当中都是名言，表示绿色是 jealousy。 Charles， what do you think of the colors of purple, blue and green
Oh, purple's the royal color、mm-hmm. in the Western world. Like over here, yellow is
a、yeah, mm-hmm.
complementary color. And blue can be for the nobility, so that we say blue blood, you know,、mm-hmm. the high class people. And green has quite a few meanings,、good and bad.、Mm-hmm. But it can say green with envy, green、mm-hmm. with jealousy. Yes,、mm-hmm. you can.
Yeah.
You can do that.
老师说绿色有好有坏，那好，当时说很青春啊，或者是 jealousy 哈，是一种妒忌。好，我们再看看这个中西成语上哈，文化差异也表现在语言上面，除刚刚意象之外，那么中西成语啦、谚语还有俚语的翻译，有时候照字面直译其实没什么意思，所以有时候我们考虑文化的意象把外国的语言用中国的这个文中我们的固有的传统啊，这种成语来翻，那么这样鲜明的溢出的含义。当有些学者认为说用中文这个中文固有的这个成语来代替翻译英文，他们觉得也不是很理想的方式了，但是这也要看情况了哈。下面一些例子我们来参考一下哈，我请魏老师帮我念英文。
As timid as a rabbit，
英文原来是这个兔子，但我们却说胆小如鼠哈。
Like a duck to water，
原文是鸭子，可是我们却说如鱼得水。
As stupid as a goose，
原来是 goose 是鹅，我们却说笨得像猪哈。
Black sheep，
我们是说害群之马，不是羊。
The apple of somebody's eye，
就说瞳孔哈，就是受人家宠爱的哈，我们却说掌上明珠了。
Gild the lily，
百合本来就很漂亮，你再把它弄金哈，就好像是画蛇添足了。
Like a cat on a hot tin roof，
就说本来是说在这很热的这屋顶上，这猫在跑，很热哈，但我们都却说是用热锅上的蚂蚁哈。
Cry up wine and sell vinegar，
这我们常听说的，叫是要酒了，可是卖的是醋，我们就用中文是用挂羊头卖狗肉。
To shed crocodile tears，
那个鳄鱼流眼泪是假的哈，我们就说猫哭老鼠。
At sixes and sevens，
我们中文说乱七八糟，英文是六和七哈，这有点不同。所以有时候翻译和文化有密不可分的关系。又如呢，假设我们要翻这个女孩美若西施，对不对？你翻成 as beautiful as 西施，我想大多数的西方人可能不是很了解哈，那也没办法联想。所以这个时候可能要参考西方文化中。谁是美女呢？美女的典范就是那个海伦，希腊那个海伦哈。所以我们翻成 as beautiful as Helen， 那么定位这个希腊神话中美女的意象哈，会使这一句话翻译的比较活泼生动哈，而且能够达意。所以翻译的时候，如果忽略文化的差异，很可能造成误解或者不了解了。我下面请老师帮我念一段很有名的话哈，关于文化跟这个翻译的语言的问题。
No language can exist unless it is steeped in the context of culture, and no culture can exist which does not have at its center the structure of natural language. Yuri Lotman.
好，我来把它翻译一下哈。诚如一位学者所说的，除非语言沉浸在文化中受其熏陶，否则语言是无法存在的。除非文化的主干是其语言自然架构，否则文化也是无法存在的。好，这是我们今天的理论部分。下面想介绍一下 famous quotations 中外名言。
Every cloud has a silver lining，
任何坏事都有好的一面，原来是说每一片乌云都镶上银边。
There is no rose without a thorn.
有快乐就有痛苦，原意是说玫瑰都有刺。
Like father, like son.
有其父必有其子。
To be as dumb as an oyster.
就说本来是说 oyster 是那个牡蛎哈，可很紧的，不张开的哈。那我们就说，哎，这个守口如瓶。
To kick down the ladder.
原来是说把楼梯给它拆了哈，过了爬了之后把楼梯拆了。但我们应该，我们中文是说过河拆桥哈。好，这是我们不大一样的地方，把比较类似的这种成语可以互相交换来翻译一下。好，现在看我们的dialogue 部分，今天谈 settling in。
Rollover time.
到期。
Certificate of deposit, CD.
定存单。
According to.
根据。
Reminder.
提醒。
Head.
朝什么方向进行？
Reinvest.
再投资。
Current.
目前的。
Interest rate.
利率。
Hectic.
忙碌的。
Will.
遗嘱。
Kin.
亲属。
Haggle.
争论、讨价还价。
Probate court.
遗嘱认证法庭。
Estate.
遗产、地产。
Real estate.
房地产、不动产。
Optimistic.
乐观的。
Regardless.
不管怎样。
Pressing matter.
紧急事件。
Job hunting.
找工作。
Sense.
感觉。
Overeducated.
教育程度过高。
Snatch.
抢夺。
Vanish.
消失。
Texas Ranger.
德州缉警。
Pistol.
手枪。
Hang in there.
坚持下去。
Survive.
存活。
Prohibitive costs.
高的负担不起的费用。好，我们来看一下今天这个 dialogue 英文的部分。
The rollover time for your CD is today, according to this.
Tell me something I don't know. Well, on second thought, thanks for the reminder. I hand on my way shortly and reinvest for another year. Wish I knew what the current interest rate is. As if that will influence the decision.
Just figured you had a hectic time since landing here last Thursday.
And still have no job or firm address. The owner of this place died all of a sudden.And evidently left no will.
That means his next of kin are haggling in probate court over the estate, such that you could be forced to move next month.
Or next, or never.
I wouldn't be that optimistic. Lee tells me they already have a new buyer.
Regardless, we've both got more pressing matters. Any luck with job hunting?
Not much. I sense it more than I know it. They'll consider us overeducated.
Such that they're afraid we'll snatch their jobs or else wait for something with higher pay to come along and vanish quicker than a Texas Ranger can draw his pistol.
We've just got to hang in there until somebody takes us on. And that's just to survive.
After which we'll be treated to less prohibited costs. Speaking of Twitch, I'd best get on there and take care of the city today.
好，我们看这一段 settling in 安定下来哈。我想问我老师 Charles, why is Texas Ranger mentioned in the dialogue?
Because they're famous for their fast draw, drawing their pistol. So you say vanish quicker than that.Then he can draw his pistol.
Then
a ranger can draw his pistol.
Yeah, Texas Ranger, 这些德州的这种缉警非常快，draw their pistol非常快。所以你说你 vanish 很快跑掉，好像比这个比那些缉警还。 拔枪还拔得快哈，表示很快的意思。Is that right? OK?、Mm-hmm. 那我们休息一下。好，那我们现在看下面这个中文的这个翻译部分。
The rollover time for your CD is today, according to this.
Tell me something I don't know. Well, on second thought, thanks for the reminder. I hand on my way shortly and reinvest for another year. Wish I knew what the current interest rate is. As if that will influence the decision.
Just figured you had a hectic time since landing here last Thursday.
And still have no job or firm address. The owner of this place died all of a sudden and evidently left no will.
That means his next of kin are haggling in probate court over the estate, such that you could be forced to move next month.
Early next, or never.
I wouldn't be that optimistic. Lee tells me they already have a new buyer.
Regardless,We've both got more pressing matters. Any luck with job hunting?
Not much. I sense it more than I know it. They'll consider us overeducated.
Such that they're afraid we'll snatch their jobs or else wait for something with higher pay to come along and vanish quicker than a Texas Ranger can draw his pistol.
We've just got to hang in there.Until somebody takes us on. And that's just to survive.
After which, we'll be treated to less prohibited costs. Speaking of Twitch, I'd best get on there and take care of the city today.
好，我们试试看 questions, 看你了解没有。
Question one, which do we learn about the woman?A, she is training to be a business executive. B, she wants to make a career in law enforcement. C, she may have to change residence very soon. D, she is trying for admission to graduate school.
C, she may have to change residence very soon.
Mm-hmm. Question two, what type of problem do both speakers now face? A, medical. B, employment. C, academic. D, legal.
B, employment.
Question three, where is the woman going immediately? A, bank. B, hospital. C, school. D, airport.
A, bank.
Question four, what do the speakers imply managers want? A, punctuality. B, alertness. C, thrift. D, longevity.
D, longevity.好，这是我们今天的这个问题哈。来，下面到我们这个 let's practice 部分哈，一起来做做看。
Wish I knew what the current interest rate is, as if that would influence the decision.
希望我知道目前的利率，这好像会影响决定似的。好，我们来学 as if 犹如好像哈，来做做看哈。他吃东西的方式好像很多天没吃了。
He ate as if he had not eaten for days. He ate as if he had not eaten for days.
哪一个错呢
？Second one's wrong.
为什么错了
？Because with had you have to use a participle. You have to say eaten.
Yeah, 过去分词是。
You can't use the unmarked form.
Yeah, eaten, E-A-T-E-N 哈。好，另外做做看。
The way he ate, it looked like he had gone days without food.
这样也可以哈。来看下一句哈，他们大大的讨论我，好像我不在这儿似的。
They talked me openly as if I was not there. They talked about me openly as if I were not there.
好，哪个错了？
The first one's wrong.
好。talk about 也是比较好哈。
Yeah, that's
as if. 这是说好像与事实相反，好像我并不在那儿。所以你要做假设语气的时候是 were 不是 was 哈。来，我们看另外的方法。
They discussed me out in the open, almost like I wasn't on hand.
我不在那儿。 好，我们看下一个例句。
The owner of this place died all of a sudden and evidently left no will.
屋主突然去世，显然没有留下遗嘱。我们看看，要 all of a sudden 突然来造个句子哈。突然间铃声大作，所有客户朝着出口跑去。我们来提示一下，出口叫 exit。
All of a sudden, the bell ringed. All customers hurried to the exit. All of a sudden, the bell rang. All customers hurried to the exit.
哪一个错了？
The first one's wrong.
为什么错？
Because ring is an irregular verb.
Ring, rang, rung, 哈，不能用这个固定的加 ed 哈，这个要小心了。那我们另外翻翻看。
Suddenly, the bell sounded, and patrons made a beeline for the exit.
好，这个响也可以用 sounded 大声响哈。那这些顾客 patrons 也可以这样说。下一句说，突然间他心脏病发，他附近的人都一片惊恐。我们提示一下，心脏病叫做
heart attack。
一片惊恐呢
？Be in a great panic。
好，试试看。
He got a heart attack all of a sudden. People around him were in a great panic.He got heart attack all of a sudden. People around him were in a great panic.
哪一个错了？
Better to put A before heart attack.
有 A 会比较好一点哈。好，另外翻翻看。
His heart attack came out of the blue and left folks nearby in wild disorder.
Out of blue 就突然的意思了哈。好，我们看下一个例句。
That means his next of kin are haggling in probate court over the estate.
这代表他的继承亲戚在遗嘱认证法庭上，争论房地产该留给谁。
Haggle，
争论或者讨价还价。好，我们来做一句。我最不喜欢讨价还价的客人。
I dislike customers whom haggle with me the most. I dislike customers who haggle with me the most.
哪一个错？
The first one
should be
because you need the subjective there instead of the objective.
Who 是主词 ，whom 是受词，不可以哈，要主词主格。好看，另外做做看。
I can't stand the sort of customer who gives me a hard time.
Okay, 这给我 hard time 哈。来，第下一句，他们一天到晚都在争论到底谁该掌权。提示一下，掌权怎么说
？Take control.
好，试试看。
They haggle about who should take control all the time. They haggle who should take control all the time.
哪一个错了
？The second one's wrong.
About 要放进去哈。好，另外做做看。
They constantly bicker about who should be in charge.
Bicker 是吵架的意思。好，我们看一下例句。
They'll consider me, us, overeducated.
他们认为我。我们受过太多教育了。我们来看一下 ，consider 是认为、考虑。做一句，不知道为什么他们觉得我不够格。
I don't know why they consider me unqualified. I don't know why they consider me unqualified.
哪一个错了？
First one sounds like Chinglish.
这中文式的说法，不够格，还有 unqualified 哈，要过去分词。好，另外做做看。
Why they look on me as less than fit mystifies me.
好，这是另外的说法哈。那我们今天就先做到这里。其实谈到翻译跟文化有很多关系哈。那么翻译也是要很多的知识去吸收，多方面去了解。那这些练习也希望你有空回去多练习一下。好，那下回见啦，拜拜。